Hi, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. It's a slow news day in the Republican Conference. I want to start by talking about what we focused on substantively in our conference this morning. And that is, as we're debating all of the big issues that we face here day in and day out in terms of legislation, and we're going to hear from the Republican leader of the Appropriations Committee, Mrs. Granger, in a moment about some of that. It's very important for us all to remember and keep in mind what's at stake in this election. What's at stake, what America would look like under a Biden, Pelosi, Schumer regime. Biden and Pelosi and Schumer, if we aren't successful at keeping the Senate, which we absolutely must be, would ensure that the United States is not able to recover from COVID for decades. We'd see increased taxes. We'd see new red tape. We've seen already efforts to kill medical innovation, to expand government authority over every aspect of our lives, to expand government programs that have been put in place for the emergency of COVID far beyond the emergency of COVID. We'd see taxpayer funding for health care for illegal immigrants. We'd see taxpayer funding for abortion. We would see efforts, and unfortunately, we would probably see success at defunding the police, the elimination of Second Amendment rights. We'd see our national defense cut. We'd see a situation in which the production of fossil fuels would be significantly curtailed, moving towards a Green New Deal. We'd see probably the end of the filibuster in the Senate. We'd see efforts to make D.C. a state. We'd see efforts to expand the size of the Supreme Court and pack it with liberal justices. There's absolutely no question what's at stake in this election and how much worse off this nation would be under a Biden, Schumer, Pelosi regime. Now, it's also important to remember that Vice President Biden, as we all know, is in his basement. Vice President Biden is in his basement partly because he's concerned about his ability to make it through an interview, but also because he doesn't want to have to talk about his socialist agenda. And we have seen consistently over the course of the last several months now, since he secured the nomination, that he has put together task forces that are co-chaired with Bernie Sanders officials, people who are tied to Bernie Sanders. I think that has never before happened. It's unprecedented historically. But while that is going on, while you've got a set of socialist policies that the vice president on one day will say he doesn't agree with and the next day will say he does, you've seen real progress from the House Republicans and also from President Trump on these key issues, issues like holding China accountable, making historic progress on Operation Warp Speed. Fundamentally, all of the debates and the discussions and the challenges that we're facing around the pandemic and around the economic devastation of the pandemic require that we develop and manufacture and distribute vaccines and therapeutics. And that is happening at an historic rate under Operation Warp Speed. You're also seeing us stand up for American freedoms and the security of our communities. You're seeing us defend the United States, defend law enforcement, fighting for real relief to get America growing again. So all of these things are fundamentally important for people to understand as we look towards the future and as we look towards what it's going to take to ensure that the Republicans get the majority back in the House and that the Republicans keep the majority in the Senate and that President Trump is reelected. These are crucial.